Good morning and happy Sabbath. Today, I'm so glad to have Heather with me.
Thank you.
It is good to share the message with my boss on the teaching car. And today's exciting because we're launching a new series.
Yeah.
There's some cooking challenges,
yep.
Right? And I was so glad to see so many of you, right, posting on WhatsApp, but we'll give people opportunity to show their dishes life as well, okay? So hanging there in the middle of the sermon, we'll have that moment about our dishes.
Yes, I can't wait. Well, 434.5 hours a week, on average, we're fed 434 hours of TV cooking a week, which means 18 days worth of food TV in a week. I don't need to tell you that cooking shows and cooking channels are a great hit nowadays. 434 hours a week dedicated to TV. What would the number of hours be if we were able to measure the cooking content on social media, YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, and others? This reality gives us an important indication that life revolves around food and around the kitchen.
In a sense, our lives orbitate around another kitchen, the heavenly kitchen. The heavenly kitchen, where God is the master chef, is a figurative, a metaphor for God's command center, God's throne room where he sovereignly sustained the universe, my life and your life. From the heavenly kitchen, God arranges, deals, manages events, circumstances, and people so you and I can come to know him, have a genuine relationship with him, and be transformed according to his image, the image of Jesus Christ.
From the heavenly kitchen, the master chef of the universe provides the means for you and I to experience a blessed life, the fullness of physical and spiritual life in the divine presence. It's from the heavenly kitchen that, even before the creation of the world, God has been dealing with human sin and suffering, providing a way out through the sacrifice of Jesus. It is in this specific subject that our series aims to focus on how the heavenly kitchen deals with human pain.
It is not an easy topic to talk about, really, with the circumstance with COVID. But it's crucial to have a glimpse of the biblical perspective about the relationship and dynamics between human suffering and God, in order to have a better understanding of who God is and his plans for us. But before we start our journey through the heavenly kitchen, let's bow our heads and seek God's direction. Heather?
Let's pray. Dear God, I just want to thank you for our time here together. Thank you for this wonderful community of people of whom we all love so much. Thank you that we have this time together to learn and to be in your presence. Please send your Holy Spirit to guide us here today into what we need to see and hear. Thank you once again for each member. Amen.
Amen.
So, one of America's most watched cooking competition shows, MasterChef, one of my favorites, has highly engaged an active social media fan base. In the iconic MasterChef Mystery Box Challenge, contestants are given a box of mystery ingredients and must create an exceptional meal to impress the judges. Contestants each have a unique take on their mystery ingredients, and the judges are presented with distinctive dishes that represent contestants' personalities.
Well, our series, The Heavenly Kitchen, we also have our Mystery Box Challenge, right? And this week, the mystery ingredient for our challenge is what?
A lemon.
Yes, that's right. Heather broke the news. I know that some of you have prepared a dish based on this week's ingredient. And you also are the judges. The winner of today's challenge, we receive what, Heather?
NP apron.
That's right.
Unfortunately, we cannot taste the dishes, and we're looking forward to that in the future. But through Poll Everywhere, you will be choosing the best dish based on three criteria. First one, uniqueness, how the dish was unique, creative, unlike any other one that you're familiar with.
The second criteria is appearance. How does the dish look like? Do you want to taste it? Right? That's the second criteria.
Right. And the third and final criteria, how the participant introduced and presented the dish. Was the dish pitch an appealing one? Well, let's turn to our first cabinet for the Heavenly Kitchen Mystery Box Challenge.
That's right. Some of you have posted your dish on WhatsApp. And that's great and that's beautiful. But we want to give opportunity for those to present their dish, because I think the third criteria, the presentation, right? How you pitch, right? How you sell your dish, it is important as well. So even though you post on the WhatsApp, if you want to speak and share a little bit and try to sell your dish, please just let Juliana know and we'll do it. I think the first one to post was Eris, right? And she put a video, how to do, right? A salad dressing using lemon. I tell you, I want to try that. I don't know if Eris want to add something else here. Are you good? Okay, let's go. The second person that posted our challenge was Joyce, right? Oh, and I was so envy of George, right? Because he was eating this lemon pound cake, right? Joyce, do you want to say something about your dish so you try to promote and sell? Let's see if, I think she want to say something.
Awesome. Yeah. I'd love to hear from people.
Yes. Hey, good to see you guys.
First dish, to tell you the truth, it was challenging. I have never zested a lemon before in my life, and I did this time. But I don't know, I just enjoyed it, and it came together really nice. So, thank you.
That's good. Well, I think we have a great, a strong candidate here, right? Let's go. I think the third person that posted was Braylon. Dawn, right? Braylon and Mary, they did some lemon scones. Oh, that's so... I don't know if Bray or Dawn wanna add something to their presentation before we vote, right? Juliana, are we okay? Should we continue? Okay, so let's go to the next one. So let's see who was the other person that posted. Oh, that was Juliana, lemon mousse, right? I don't know, Juliana Everton, do you wanna say something? Yeah, Everton can go, yeah, sure. Okay, so Everton will explain and try to sell because he is crazy for this NFT, right?
He right? wants the apron really badly.
Yeah, and he wants two. Okay, Everton, are you ready? Oh, he's coming here! Oh my, I thought you were...
It's harder to do that way. Hello, everyone. So this is a Brazilian delight. It's a very famous dessert. It's like to celebrate the beginning of spring. Me and Juliana, we can enjoy a very delicious mousse. A lemon mousse. It's very simple to do and to prepare. And if you like, we can share with you the recipe later, but only if I get the apron.
That was a nice speech. Thank you for that. Okay, Juliana, you said that you want to add something? Oh, okay. Olivia mentioned that everything that Auntie Juliana does is amazing. So, yeah, you
keep
should
that
try.
In mind.
That's great. So, let's see the next person that posted was Anna, right? Mm. A salad dressing as well. Anna, do you want to share something else? Yes, she does.
Awesome.
So, yeah, everybody wants to get this apron, right? Okay, Anna, go ahead. Good morning.
Sorry, I pressed the wrong thing, I guess. Can you guys hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yeah, okay, good. So, yeah, I won't win this competition because nothing creative about that, okay? But if you guys want to vote out of love, okay, I love you guys too, so you can vote. I love the apron. It's not creative, but it's something that it's super simple and it's my go-to recipe for salad dressing. So it's, I use lemon because of the competition, but use lime, olive oil and salt. So you can use that for greens, for leaves, and for any salad like this one. So you can have anything you have in the fridge, like vegetables, something fresh, you can chop, put in there, and add lime juice, lemon juice, olive oil and salt. Mm-hmm. If you have like cilantro, fresh cilantro, parsley,
okay, let's stop. Let's stop here. There's too much information. I'm hungry already. Thank you, Anna. And you know, that's so important for us because that's part of our mission and vision, mm-hmm. right? Do life together. So even though maybe it's not, like, say, biblically oriented, I think it's go along with who we are,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
And that's great. So the next one, we think we have, oh, yeah, the lens, right? Lexi, a lemon garland cream pasta. Oh, my. Lexi, do you want to share a little bit about your dish? Yes, I think she want to say something. Yeah, yes, good.
Yeah, I made this pasta this morning. It's the first time that I made it, so it didn't turn out perfect, but it still tasted really good. You can taste the lemon in all of it, but if you ask anybody in this house, I like making pasta and the sauces. During COVID, I tried to make pasta, but it didn't turn out too good. Yeah, I don't know. I had a lot of fun, but, and I think I'd try this again because it turned out pretty good.
Oh, that's
looks
great.
Nice.
Ooh, yeah. Thank you, Alexi. Yeah. I want to try later.
I hope it's featured at NP Potluck soon.
Yeah, that's right. And this coming week, we'll have another challenge, right? Okay. So we have at least two people that said that they have prepared a dish that they want to present and tell us about. And I think let's go with whom first. Oh, Rebecca. Or it's Olivia's or Rebecca's?
It's both. We work together. We are a team. What did we make, Olivia?
My favorite dish of all.
And what is it? Tell people about it.
A lemon pie.
It's a lemon pie. It's obviously Brazilian dessert with sweet condensed milk. It's not news to you guys that we use that a lot as Brazilians. So we made like a butter, a crust with flour, and we made it fresh. We actually bought the one, but we thought we were cheating, so we did the fresh one this morning. And then we have the middle is sweet condensed milk with lime, just that. A lot of lime, a little bit of lemon. I mean, a lot of lemon and a little bit of lime to make it quite zesty. And then the top is just egg whites with lemon zest and sugar.
It was messy.
It was messy, but it turned out, I think, okay, right? Yeah, so that's, I think, I would love to share a piece with you guys. I think that if you were to eat this, you might think about voting for us. So yeah, that's our pitch. Good, anything else you wanna say?
Eat it,
yes, we're gonna eat it. Thank you.
That's great. So now, since I was here at my home, let's go to your home.
Yes.
Because I think Madeline has a dish for us as well. Hey, good to see you guys.
Good to see you guys.
I made a lemon, a meringue nest with lemon curd and a lemon mousse with lemon curd at the bottom.
Wow. That is great.
I'm looking forward to having it for lunch.
Yes, I can't wait to get home.
That's great. Well, thank you everyone for preparing your dish. Is there anybody else that would like to share with us your dish at this moment? Or are those the candidates for today? And I know we just need to pick one today.
Yeah.
But next week
we'll go on from there.
Yeah, we have at least six in total six challenges, right? And today was the easiest one, right?
I think so. Yeah, who doesn't okay. like a lemon?
So let's go to poll everywhere. And I wanna ask you just to vote in one, okay? And they are in the poll. Yeah, I put them in the poll. Yeah, you can play the poll. Juliana will say, did you put Madeline? Yeah, I was able to edit the poll here on my cell phone. So, we'll come. Yes. So who you want to have to get is the winner for today. And I allowed four people to vote. It's not for you to vote four times, but sometimes in your home, there are other people, right? And they need... you have just one device, so allow you just one vote per person if possible, right? So let's give some time here and let's see who's getting today's prize.
Oh my.
So far, Madeline is leading, and that's great. And by the way, if you win today or win any other week, you can for sure participate on the other challenge, but you'll be not allowed to get the apron, right?
Yeah, that's only fair.
Yeah, let's give other people opportunity. Otherwise, maybe Madeline will get all them, right? And I think, should we give 5 more seconds? And here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's done.
Okay.
Okay. So Heather, you're taking the apron. Let me show here, right? Everton said, oh, you should preach with the apron, right? Look, you're taking this one to Madeline. Maybe we should preach, right?
And maybe we should.
Yeah. And even Everton, he said, oh, will not feed on me, I need you. Yeah, he tried it and you go. So Heather, you're taking this one with you today.
Well, thanks everybody. That was amazing. I loved to see your dishes, and seriously, we're gonna have an MP Pollock one of these days featuring lemon.
For sure.
So some of you made wonderful dishes and helped others helped by being judges. Next week's gonna be an all new challenge, and you will have another opportunity to win an MP apron.
The creativity and the ability of adaptation in these mystery box challenges always amazes me. In the same way, I'm amazed how God has to deal with the mystery box ingredients of my life and everyone's life. Don't take me wrong, I'm not implying that God is caught by surprise. I do believe that God knows the past, the present, and the future completely. God is never surprised. However, what I'm most impressed with is how, in the heavenly kitchen, God is able to use some ingredients that He would not choose for us. Ingredients that sometimes we threw at Him.
Our divine master chef in His heavenly kitchen takes these ingredients and transforms them into a blessed dish for us. Romans 8:28 says, and we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to His purpose. Now, the way we see and understand this Bible verse, and in a sense, what happens at the heavenly kitchen, is related to what I believe about God. How I see God, my beliefs as to how He interacts with humans shapes my reading, my understanding of the suffering in the world and in my life.
There is a belief, a popular assumption among Christians and non-Christians, that there is a form of predestination or predeterminism, known in academic circles as theological determinism. With theological determinism, God is the active, sufficient cause of everything in the created world, either directly or by secondary causes, such as human agents.
In other words, theological determinism is the belief that all the events are determined or necessitated by God. It is the popular belief, God's will. Everything is God's will. Something happened, it was because of God's will.
Something did not happen because of God's will.
The car accident, God's will.
That disease, God's will.
COVID, God's will.
The promotion, God's will.
That score on your paper, God's will.
Humans playing nothing or a macroscopic part because everything is about God's will.
We are merely puppets in God's play.
There is no such thing as free will. Everything is part of God's plan, according to this way of thinking.
With such a belief, God knows the future, so people assume that he caused the actions so the predefined future will take place. God knows the future because he caused it.
Through the lens of the theological determinism, the heavenly kitchen is the place where God releases his dishes without us ordering them or even liking them.
Our feelings, desires, or preferences don't matter because what really is important is God's plan, God's will. Our part is to eat the dish and be quiet because even pain and suffering are part of his sovereign plan.
I don't think I need to break down how problematic this view is. However, sometimes even unconsciously, we see good Christians propagating this view. It's God's will.
If it was God's will that there was the death of a baby, a car accident, an earthquake, famine, and so many disasters, if all of that is part of God's will and plan, personally, I don't want anything to do with a God like that.
In my humble opinion, such an understanding about God has its roots more in paganism than the scriptures. I cannot see God being the source of both evil and pain.
As we have studied before, God is the loving, good, perfect, and unchanging provider who blesses us daily with his presence and for our spiritual and material needs because of his nature, because of who he is. He is a giver of good and perfect things by nature. Every good and perfect gift is from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation of shadow or turning. James 1:16-17.
According to the Bible, everything that comes out from God is good and perfect, and his nature cannot be changed. Look what the Bible says at the end of the creation week. God looked over everything he had made. It was good. So very good. If there's something that is not good in your life, it did not come from God. We need to realize that if for some reason we are experiencing pain and suffering, it did not originate with God.
Yes, pain and suffering don't come from God's hand. Jesus made it clear in the parable of the weeds of Matthew 13. In verse 27 and 28, there is a crucial question and answer related to the cause or source of suffering and pain. It says, "So the farmer's hired hands came to him and said, 'Sir, wasn't that good seed that you sowed in the field? Where did all those weeds come from?' He answered, 'This has to be the work of an enemy.'"
The source of suffering and pain is related to the work of an enemy of God and not God. Don't get me wrong here. I do not believe that all the pain and suffering directly originates with Satan. I would not create another kind of theological determinism attributing all pain and suffering as a direct action of the devil. I know that indirectly, as part of the work of the enemy, we can trace suffering and pain to the ancient serpent, who is called the devil, the deceiver of the whole world.
Pain and suffering can have many sources, such as the devil himself, our own actions, other people's actions, and the broken system of sin that we live in. The point of this message is not to trace the cause of suffering, but to present what God is able to do in his kitchen.
The master chef is able to take whatever, independent of the source, whatever is the devil, you, other people, or the broken system, whatever. No matter the source, the divine master chef is able to turn the mystery ingredients that landed in his kitchen into a blessing.
Yes, the heavenly kitchen is the business of blessings. If we allow him, we'll experience his blessings. And the most important blessing, God's presence and the love, grace, mercy, forgiveness, salvation, and life that his presence brings. And we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. Romans 8:28.
Personally, I know how it hurts. I know it is not easy to deal with the undesired situations of life. At times, it is not easy to understand what goes on in the heavenly kitchen. Sometimes it is difficult to see any blessings coming out from some situations.
When we don't understand the circumstances around us, we need to cling to what we know about God, the loving, good, perfect, and unchanging provider who is in his kitchen, cooking in a way that at the end, all things will work out for our good, for our salvation. Every single day, every circumstance, we need to trust the divine master chef.
Maybe you're watching us right now and are feeling lost because you don't know what is going on in the heavenly kitchen. It is hurting, and you don't know what to think or what to do. I want you to believe with all your heart that God is looking at you at this very moment. Your tears have not been gone unnoticed by Him. Your pleas and prayers have been heard by the loving God. At this moment, He's turning to you. Yeah, He's turning to you right now. With His loving and caring voice. And He says to you at this moment the following.
We'll find us.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, it is good to know that you are the loving, amazing, awesome God. That everything that comes out of your hands is good. Unfortunately, we live in a broken system of pain, suffering, death, diseases, hospitals. And we know that that's not your plan for us. That's not your will for us. Because the same way that breaks my heart when my little Christopher and my little package Olivia, they face a problem, I can imagine how your heart is broken when you see us suffering. Sometimes the suffering comes from the devil, from other people's decisions and actions, our own actions and bad choices, or even just the broken system. This system of sin after more than 6,000 years. But at the end, we know that you give us strength and encouragement to face everything until that day that we will not face pain, suffering, tears, or death anymore. We know that you're trying to do your best with the circumstances that land to into your kitchen so those can become a blessing to us. So Lord, help us to hang on you. Help us throughout this series to understand your love and how you work through these undesired moments. Bless everyone that is listening to my voice. And if for some reason someone needs healing, Lord, touch this person's life. If someone needs an embrace now, Lord, embrace with your loving arms. If someone needs to be carried, Lord, take them in your arms. Give us a great Sabbath day and be with us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.